First of all, if you can sort of compartmentalize the auto industry for a moment in terms of the core business, fundamental, you know, building and selling of vehicles, and then separately sort of the technology narrative that we can touch on momentarily. But I think as it relates to the core business, there's sort of this wall of worry, right? I mean, we're very late in the auto sales cycle, and we've seen sales start to plateau. We've got aluminum and steel tariffs pressuring costs of goods sold. And I think what we saw yesterday in the reaction was sort of a de-risking of part of the trade issues, right? There's this broader trade issue with China, but clearly from a NAFTA perspective, you know, significant production investments have been made into Mexico, both from vehicle assembly and as well, you know, via third-party parts suppliers. So to see some resolution is clearly a positive, but we're a long way from sort of overall resolution. You know, Canada is a much bigger impact for Ford and GM specifically, and so, you know, we think that the stocks remain range bound here until we can kind of see what Canada's impact is here from the ongoing discussions.
Does a trade deal, a global trade deal, figuring out the issues with China and such, does that spark a resumption in the global buying of cars, or does it just slow down the decline?
It's a great way to frame it, I think. I think it's more the latter. It does work to sort of de-risk a industry that we already see is in a little bit of cyclical decline in some areas of the auto industry, particularly around compact cars and the lack of demand there. We're seeing some structural or sort of secular decline. So at the end of the day, you know, this is about managing through sort of the imposed risk as it relates to ongoing global trade disputes.